The Riverdale football team suffered the loss of a teammate before the start of last season. Zach Polsenberg died of heat stroke during a workout. Now, a little over 15 months later, the Raiders are having their greatest success ever on the field.
NBC2's Sean Barry has their incredible success story and how they stand on the verge of making history.
It's a football season few, if any, outside of the Riverdale program saw coming. But after 8 weeks, the Raiders are still undefeated and already have punched their ticket to the postseason.
You know, I knew that we had a chance to be pretty special. I think our kids have proven that.
Hard work can get a football team far, and it's that hard work the members of the Riverdale Raiders credit for one of the greatest seasons in program history.
It's been hard sometimes, it's been easy, but all the hard work we've been putting in, and listen to our coaches and committing to the ship.
Our kids play hard as heck for one another. They care about each other, and it's amazing to see them get the fruits of all their hard work so soon.
8 weeks into the season, and the Raiders are still undefeated and have already qualified for the playoffs, winning just their third district title in program history and first in 9 years.
We don't want to have that mindset, oh, we have a district championship. We don't want to stop there. We just want to keep going, keep going, keep going, keep going.
However, it's a season born out of tragedy after their teammate Zach Polsenberg died from heat stroke just before last season. Even now, though, Polsenberg inspires the Raiders.
Every game, every practice, we think about him. Every time we leave the locker room, his jersey's right there, number 72. It just reminds us that it can be taken away from us at any point in time.
Inspiring them to become the first team in program history to finish the regular season undefeated.
Nobody can take that away from them. Now we're working towards something greater.
The Raiders look to wrap up an undefeated season this Friday, but it won't be easy. They're welcoming a very good Golden Gate team to their home field. Reporting in Fort Myers, Sean Barry, NBC2.